estimate.
We are all geared up, literally, for Chef Jeff Bragg with Sur La Table. Good to have you on.
I'm happy to be back.
And thanks for the apron.
Oh, it looks lovely.
Look, it matches, you know, the outfit and everything. And we're making pizza on the grill, right?
Mm-hmm. We are making pizza on the grill. We'll be teaching this class tomorrow night at Sur La Table. So I thought it'd be fun to share the technique of grilled pizza today.
Oh, excellent, mm-hmm. excellent. We've all got the grills out anyway this summer, right?
Exactly. It's a great time, and it's not your first go-to generally when you're thinking about the grill.
Right, you're
But
right.
it's actually fun, and it's easy to set up as a pizza party. And
okay.
So right over here we have our hot grill, and if you
yes,
can imagine I should be outside.
Yes, very hot.
And we had rolled the pizza out, and we laid it right on top of the grill. And if you could just pull that up, we're going to lay it over here
I
on our
like
pizza
I'm,
peel.
We're burning it, but that's not the case,
no,
right?
Not
we're just
at
trying
all.
To get those nice grill marks.
Yeah, a couple of grill marks. And you can see we started to get a little bit of brown here, and I have one prepped up over here already.
And these are the grill what mm-hmm. we want our grill marks to look
yeah.
like here. Right?
That's exactly it. You're perfect. That's great.
Okay.
So let's go ahead and pull that one off, and you can lay it right next to this, and I'm going to put some toppings on.
Okay.
But
excellent.
In the meantime, I think I have a couple in here that are coming up, so I'm going to pull these out of the oven, nice and hot.
I want to make sure they're good and tasty for when you need somebody to taste it at
yeah,
the
I'm
end
gonna,
of the segment. Oh,
yeah.
Sammy Joe's already volunteered over there. Okay.
Great.
And we won't reveal the final yet, right? Because yeah. we want to show people some of the toppings that we can put on. Can
Absolutely.
We get creative, kind of do our own thing
yeah,
here?
Yeah, to be honest, our pizza classes generally degrade into a sort of a build-your-own pizza party because we have a lot of set recipes.
Okay.
But when people have all this stuff laid out in front of them, they just start putting together whatever they like.
All right.
So, right
what
now,
did you just layer on?
I have some grilled peaches I put on top and a little prosciutto and just... for fun, and because it's a nice crowd pleaser, I also have some fresh sliced Roma tomatoes and mozzarella
for our mozzarella. Okay.
For our margarita. And if you notice, we also put a little cornmeal down on our pizza peel. That sort of gives our pizza crust wheels when we go to pop them into the oven so they don't stick to the board.
Okay, so we don't put it back on the grill and let the grill...
No. Well, you could put it on the grill. Right now, we can't really create the ambient heat we need to like get the toppings crusty, so we're going to finish in the oven. But
okay.
you could totally finish
could
on the grill.
Totally
you just drop the lid.
On the
yeah, put on
okay.
the grill. And,
how
shut
hot should the grill be? And you know, you don't want it...
That's a good question.
Yeah.
You should have a nice hot side for searing your crust, and then a cooler side for letting your pizza finish. Once
and letting the mm-hmm. cheese melt, especially if you're using
Absolutely.
That mozzarella. Okay.
So I'm going to shut this off so we don't get too hot over here.
Oh, yeah. The fire alarm's about to go off here in a second.
So we have these two pizzas to finish. This is arugula on top, and it's a nice way to finish a fresh pizza. Again, not a quick go-to, but a little bit of balsamic vinaigrette. That's just a little bit of olive oil and balsamic vinegar.
Okay.
And the same thing over here. I like fresh toppings, so we're going to finish...
with, we're not going to let you go without tasting this thing. Come over here, Sammy Joe. You're like hovering over here because you want to get a taste of this too.
I do.
That looks. Which one do you want to try?
I want to try the less messy one.
The less messy one.
They're both
going
to be
okay.
Here, let me cut it up for you.
Okay, look, we're about to get our hands on that thing.
Now, if you want to make your own, of course, you can come to our classes. You just have to go to surlatab.com to register.
Yeah.
How long does this take altogether?
I made the pizza dough yesterday.
Okay.
We grilled the pizza dough in about, maybe like 3 minutes.
Mm-hmm.
I put it on right before the break. And then we finished it in the oven over here for another 3 to 4 minutes. You're not going to get the same degree of crispiness you might get if you do a whole pizza in the oven. But when you sort of make up for it with all the flavors you get off the grill.
She's brave, but I'm not going to eat this on air. I'm going to inhale this. Thank you so much.
My pleasure. Thanks for coming on.
Eat and run. What kind of guest are you?
We got plenty more
I
for everybody
else. I love the balsamic vinegar on this.
It is great.
It's excellent.
Yeah, it's a great pair up against the peaches and the salty prosciutto.
Mm-hmm. And really quickly, again, classes available at Sur La Table.
At Sur La Table. Go to surlatable.com. You can get class descriptions. That's also where you register for our classes. And if you're kind of anxious about trying it for the first time, July 15th through the 21st, all of our classes are on sale for 50% off. So it's a great time to just try it out.
All right.
Yeah.
Thank you, Chef Jeff.
My pleasure.
This is excellent. We'll be back right after this break. Stay with us.